Hello everyone, welcome back. So in this lecture I am going to discuss about the modification of insect leg. So we know that insects possess three pair of legs. They are present on all the thoracic segments, that is prothorax, mesothorax and metathorax. These legs are actually the major locomotory organs in case of insects. Because of presence of three pair of legs, insects are also known as hexapods, or the class insecta is also called as class hexapoda. So in different insects, these legs are modified for the different purposes. So we are going to study about the different types of legs. They are modified for different purposes. So if we are talking about a typical structure of an insect leg, so an insect leg consists of five segments. That is, first is coxa. So it is the first and basal segments. It is fixed to the thorax or weakly articulated. Then there is a smallest segment called trochanter is present in between the coxa and femur. Then there is a longest and largest strongest segment, that is femur. It is the third segment. Then there is tibia. This tibia is the fourth segment, and it may be as equal to the femur or it may be larger than the femur. Then this tibia at its end possess tibial spurs. These spurs are very important. They are taxonomically very important. They are used for the identification of some of the insects. Then there is a segment called tarsus. So tarsus is many segmented. You can see here, and each tarsal segment is known as tarsomere. You can see here the first tarsal segment is larger than all the other tarsal segments. Hence, it is also known as vasitarsus. This tarsus is ends in a pretarsus, and pretarsus in a these structures called claws. So this pretarsus is actually a part of tarsus. It is not a separate segment. So total segments are five only. In some books they have mentioned pretarsus as a separate segment. So please remember that this pretarsus is a segment of tarsus only. So in some insects this pretarsus consists of some of the special structures. Like you can see here, if these are cushion like structures are present in these with this class, it is known as pulvilli. And in between, if this lobe like structure is present, it is called as aerolium. And if this spine like structure is present, it is called as impodium. So this impodium is present in case of this impodium and pulvilli both are present in case of all the legs of the house flies, that are also known as sticking type of legs. We'll discuss in coming slides. So coming to the first type of legs, called cursorial legs. They are modified for the running purposes. So in case of ants, cockroaches and tiger beetles, you might have seen these ants are running very fast. So because of their legs. So these type of legs have no any special modifications, but they are suited for the running purposes. You can see here. Then coming to the ambulatorial legs, they are modified for the walking purposes. So in case of grasshoppers, fore and middle legs, you can see here, fore and middle legs are modified for the walking purposes. However, these hind legs are modified for the jumping purposes. We'll discuss in next slide. So here these legs are modified for the walking purposes, ambulatorial type. Then coming to the saltatorial type, this is what we are talking. Jumping or leaping type. So these hind legs of the grasshoppers and crickets, these are modified for the jumping or leaping purposes. So femur and tibia, you can see here, femur and tibia are elongated. That actually help in the jumping. Then coming to the next, that is fossorial type or digging type. You might have seen these dung rollers. In rainy season, they're making a ball and they take this ball to their ground homes They make a hole in the ground with the help of their four legs, and they put this ball and inside their home, and they lay eggs inside this ball. So the four legs of the dung rollers and mole crickets, these are modified for the digging purposes. Here you can see tibia and tarsus are short and broad with teeth-like structures. You can see here. So these teeth-like structures actually help in digging the soil. Then coming to the raptorial type of the legs, they are also known as grasping type of legs. They are modified for the catching prey. So in case of praying mantids, four legs are modified for capturing the prey. You can see here tibia, femur and tibia possess spine-like structures. These spine-like structures actually help in capturing the prey very tightly. So these are spines, actually these are the outgrowths from the integument or body wall. They help in the capturing the prey. They are these four legs are not used for the walking or any other purposes. They are only used for the capturing the prey. So these praying mantids are actually beneficial insects. They feed on other insects, so they are our friends. Then coming to the fifth type of insect leg, that is natatorial type of legs. These legs are modified for the swimming purposes. The hind legs in case of water beetles and water bugs. So this natatorial type of legs actually present in aquatic insects. So hind legs of the water beetles and water bugs. This tibia and tarsus you can see here are short. They are not very large, but they have long, dense marginal hairs. These hairs actually help in swimming to these insects. Then coming to the scansorial type of legs, these are also known as clinging type of legs. All legs of the head louse. You can see here that tibia possess tibial thumb. Tibia possess tibial thumb. Tarsus single segmented. You can see here tarsus. Single segmented, this tarsus and with a pre-tarsus with a single long curved claw, and this actually, this structure is actually helping the clinging to the head louse. So please remember that scansorial type of legs are present in head louse. Then coming to the prehensile type of the legs, they are also modified for the capturing the prey or catching the prey. So all the legs of the dragonflies are modified in such a way to capture the prey. So they are also known as basket forming type. These legs are modified in such a way that they are look like that they form a basket, and these are these dragonflies are capable of capturing the prey even under flight also because of their well developed prehensile type of legs. So these legs are not used for the walking or running purposes. They are used for the sitting and for capturing these preys. So please remember that prehensile type or catching type of legs are present in dragonflies, and all the three pair of legs are modified for this purpose. Then coming to the next type of legs, that is sticking type of legs. So these sticking type of legs are present on the houseflies. All the three pair of thoracic legs are modified for the sticking, what we are discussing in the previous slide in the structure of insect leg. So here you can see these are the claws, and this is the this pulvili, lobe-like structures, and this spine-like structure, this is impodium, and these are hairs are present, and the hairs secrete some of the sticky materials that actually help in sticking these houseflies on ceiling. Because of this type of legs, they are not slipping on ceiling in our home. Then coming to the legs of the honeybees. So in case of honeybees, all the three pair of legs are modified for different purposes. Like first pair of leg or front leg are modified for the antennae cleaning type. So you can see here tibia possess movable spine, the first tarsal segment with a semicircular notch. This semicircular notch, this actually help in the antennae cleaning, and this is also known as antennae cleaner or antennal cleaner. Then coming to the middle legs, these are known as back speaking type. They are modified for the back speaking or removing the backs from the ventral surface of the abdomen. Actually, these honeybees have four pair of back glands that are present on the fourth to seventh abdominal segment. These secrete backs, and this backs is separated by these middle legs, and then this backs is used for the comb building. Then these hind legs are modified for the pollen collecting type. They are also known as pollen basket or pollen brush type. These hind legs, you can see here, inner surface of large tibia has a groove. You can see here groove, and is used as pollen basket. And this pollen basket is also called as carbicula for the temporary storage of the pollen grains, because these pollen grains are removed after coming to the hive. First tarsal segment is enlarged and possesses short, stiff hairs called pecten all over the surface, and these hairs actually help in formation of pollen basket. So you can see, this is the pollen basket, this is pollen comb, and this is pollen press. This structure is pollen press. This actually help in the pressing the pollens. You might have seen this type of pollen collected by these honeybees in case of Apis mellifera. So in such a way, these honeybees are capable of collecting pollens. Then coming to the legs of the immature stages. So we know that exopterygoton insects, their immature stage is called nymph, but nymphs are look like adults. So they have three thoracic legs only, and these thoracic legs are actually true legs. However, in case of endopterygoton immature stages, that is larva, they possess two types of legs. These are thoracic legs or true legs. They are present on the all the three thoracic segments, and then abdominal segments are abdominal legs are pseudo legs or false legs. They are present on abdomen to hold the abdomen, because this abdomen is very large. So during feeding or walking, this needs to be held by some structures. So these pro legs are actually there to hold this elongated abdomen. And these pro legs at its tips, there is a structure called planta that actually help in sticking on the plant surface. This actually, this have a hook like structure. Planta, this have a hook like structure that actually helps for the clinging or sticking to the surface. This if we are talking about the number of the prolegs, they may be one or maybe five or 1 to 5, and they are usually present on 3rd to 6th and 10th abdominal segments. In some insects, these legs are actually degenerated or not present in case of coccidae and endoparasitic Hymenoptera, etc. So this is all about the insect legs. If you have any confusion, any doubts, please comment below. Thank you.